What's going on YouTube? Jake here with Venture Visuals, and today we are going to be breaking down this dope stutter effect for music videos, which can also be used in any type of creative edit. This effect is very customizable and it's a great way to add some flair to your next edit. But before we begin, I just want to say thank you so much for clicking on my video. If you are a creative person who's interested in being a part of a community of other creative people, definitely consider hitting the subscribe button down below. I'm dropping a lot of new tutorials and a lot of new visual assets this year, which are going to be really helpful for your visual projects. The main goal is to show you guys out there the amazing tools and resources that we have at our disposal to be creative. Say we are going to be using Adobe Premiere Pro for this video, but this effect can be done in a lot of different editing software. It's really just the fundamental technique of creating the stutter effect that I'm going to be showing you guys today. So here on my timeline, I have two clips that are a part of a music video. No edits happening in between these two clips, not even color corrected or anything. These are just the raw clips synced up with the audio. I really like using this stutter effect on hi-hats, and this song is a classic trap song, so it has a lot of hi-hats. It has a lot of potential for this stutter effect. So listening to the song, I can tell there's a lot of hi-hat hits here after this kick drum, which happens during this part of the song. So there's a lot of hi-hats in between this next kick drum and this kick drum right here. So that's a good spot to try this stutter effect out. So I'm gonna make a cut where these hi-hats start. I'm gonna go ahead and click C on my keyboard and then make a cut right there. And I'm gonna delete this clip in between, right? So now we just have this first clip and this second clip with this gap in between. What I'm gonna do is hold option on this first clip and drag it up. Just go over to the left four frames. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna cut this top clip, this new clip. So I'm gonna drag this clip now to the end, and I'm gonna hit Command R in reverse this clip. And now what I'm going to do is just hold option and copy this clip along the timeline. Let's go maybe like four times right there. So now you can see the stutter effect happening, but it's not timed up perfectly with the hi-hats. So what I'm going to do is just click and drag these stutters that we just made. I'm going to drag them around here on the timeline until I get them timed up perfectly with the hi-hat. So that looks way better to me. That looks way more on beat. And then what we're going to do is drag this second clip over. Now what I'm going to do is just scale up the position of these stutters so that we're a little bit more zoomed in on the stutter effect. So I'm going to scale in that position, hit Command C, Command V on these other stutter clips right here. So we're a little bit more zoomed in than the original. So as you can see, you know, there's the original clip and then boom, there's the stutter. You know, it's a little bit more zoomed in. It looks a little different before we go into the next clip. Now what I like to do on top of this is add an overlay on top. I do have a couple of these glitch overlays, which you can download. And these glitch overlays look really cool on top of like stuttery, glitchy type effects. So what I'm gonna do is just take this glitch overlay here and I'm gonna drag it into my timeline above my stutter clips. I'm gonna go ahead and cut the excess off of that. We only want this glitch to happen over where the stutter is happening. And now what I'm gonna do is change the blending mode of this glitch from normal to screen. So now we get these glitched lines that pop up during our stutter effect. And now all together, it's gonna look like this. You can play around with the speed of these stutters. You can play around with the positioning of these stutters. You can play around with the scale of these stutters. It's all very, very customizable. This is just the fundamental technique for creating your own stutter effects, right? So I really do also like these overlays. We can go ahead and grab another glitch overlay from my pack. Let's go ahead and throw two on the same clip, right? So now we have two different types of glitch overlays on the same stutter effect. And now when we play that back, let's check out what that looks like. So that is really sick also. I really like the way that's looking. So again, all we did was we chopped the tail end of this clip below. We copied it. We reversed it, right? So Command R reversed it. Then we just copy pasted that four times over, leading into the next clip, right? So there it is. And then what we did is just zoomed in the scale a little bit to make those clips look a little bit different than the original. And then we added the glitch overlays on top of that. So if you can't wait to try this effect out in your next edit, definitely hit the like button down below. And if you are a video editor, you should definitely check out my overlays, transitions, and a bunch of other stuff I have on my website. I'll include a link below. And please comment below if you're having any problems or trouble at all implementing this stutter effect in your own music videos or creative edits. And until next time, guys, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.